Yo, 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 what's the goddamn deal, man? It's your boy Vibingwithfred. We back with another video. Listen, today it's gonna be a vlog style video, man. So just rock with your boy, all right? So I know I got a lot of different types of subscribers who watch my content, man. And we gonna be starting off our day, right? You know what I'm saying? So it's the morning time right now. I got my hair cut. Well, I got trimmed up recently, right? But it's been a couple days, you know what I'm saying? And my hair be growing back quick as hell. So I'm gonna just be showing y'all some of just like the little basic shit that I be doing, you know what I'm saying? Always, bro, make sure your shit is, let me call this goddamn camera. Make sure your shit is always trimmed and nice, you know what I'm saying? Females, no matter where you are in the world, bro, I'm not gonna just make this about Brazil. No matter where you are in the world, females always want a dude that got nice, clean shaving, all right? So get your goddamn clippers, man, and just touch it up, you know what I'm saying? Just touch it up. I've never met one girl who was like, I like my dude to be all scruffy, roughy, and dusty. I've never met them, you know what I'm saying? I damn sure didn't meet them in the States. And if you ain't meet them in the States, we know they got the most unrealistic and idiotic expectations. So, you know what I'm saying? Just line your shit up. And I got a bump right here. I need to get rid of that. Just line your shit up. You can go get some of these clippers from your local Walmart. You know what I'm saying? I brought these with me. I got these from Walmart. They not like the hella cheap ones, but you want them to do the job. You know what I'm saying? You want to be able to make people look at you when you walk into a room, bro. You know what I'm saying? That's why I say physical appearance is important. Now, if you don't have a beard, bro, that's not the end all be all. Because I have two different looks. I got the beard game, and then I'll cut this off where I just have the goatee. Now, it all depends. I know a lot of women here like dudes with beards, but there's also dudes who have just straight goatees. There's also dudes who don't have shit, right? But I'm gonna just keep it 100, bro. I feel like guys, when they wear like a full beard, it just gives you that manly look. You feel me? You won't see that too much here in Salvador. There's a lot of guys who don't have facial hair, or they just wear like the goatee style, like right here. So you won't see that too much. I mean, there, you will see it, but it's not too much. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna keep it 100. I personally don't like a lot of fucking body hair, and my shit be growing like right here and on my stomach and shit. So I cut that shit off. You feel me? I'm just talking to y'all like a big brother. You know what I'm saying? A best friend. Your homie, your uncle, because we got all different types of age and demographic, you know what I'm saying? All different ages and shit. So some people might be a little younger than other ones. I'm 31. So I'm going to be your best friend, man. Shave the goddamn body hair, bro. You know what I'm saying? If you have hella body hair, like, I don't know. I just never met females, again, who think that shit is just sexy. You feel me? So with that being said, shave your goddamn body hair. You know what I'm saying? Brush your teeth. If your teeth are not completely straight, which I need to go get fucking braces, bro. I'm going to keep it 100 with y'all. I need to get braces. You know what I'm saying? I would say that's one of my biggest fucking flaws is I need braces. But at the same time, it don't stop me from getting shit. So you don't have to be completely fucking flawless and perfect, or this Chad or whatever the fuck y'all be saying, bro. But you could just be a regular guy, you know what I'm saying? I'm a regular guy, but I make sure that I got my shit on point. You feel me? Anyways, hit the goddamn like button, man. Hit the goddamn like button. Like I said, we waiting on Austin. He at the gym right now. And I'm just getting ready. You know what I'm saying? We're about to hit the streets and bring y'all some content. You know what I'm saying? By the time, I don't even know the title of this video. Well, by the time I edit this shit up, I will. But I'm just showing y'all what I do typically in the mornings. I'll hit the beard, make sure my shit is straight, which I'm probably just going to go back in and touch up some shit. Make sure the neck is good. I'm going to get this fucking body hair off of me, off my chest and shit. And, yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? Oh, I'm going to show y'all another thing, man, because I know a lot of y'all is like, what do you wear? You know what I'm saying? What do you wear? So I'm going to show y'all everything, bro. Another thing I will say is that you don't need to wear, I mean, you don't need to have tattoos. I know I seen in the last video I posted, I was on a live stream last night with Austin, and there was people talking about, I'm going to get tattoos. Bro, don't do anything fucking different. Don't modify shit on your body to try to attract other women, bro. Like, it's not that deep, honestly. Like, if you have to do that shit, then just fucking stay where the fuck you at. And even if you're in the States, bro, never get anything to, like, enhance as far as, like, tattoo. Get tattoos because you fucking love tattoos, bro. Don't get it to try to pull more bitches. Like, that shit lame as hell, you know what I'm saying? Whatever you get it because you like it. Don't get it because the next man got it and you see him with success. Because then you're just going to be looking stupid. You get tattoos and you just hella tatted up now. And you still ain't getting no play. You still ain't getting no buns. So that shit lame as hell, bro. If you literally want to get a chick, just work on yourself and work with what you got, bro. Hit the gym, eat good, drink water, get rest. And you know what I'm saying? Make sure you well-groomed and shit. And take care of the shit that you have. If you want tattoos, get them hoes because you like them. You know what I'm saying? Don't get them for nothing else. So whatever you get, don't get it for a chick, bro. You know what I'm saying? Get it because you like that shit. Anyways, this is some, I'm going to show you guys this little durag bae got me this. You know what I'm saying? Just like a little fragrance. Spray that shit on, bro. Spray this shit on, man. Oh, shit. That shit got in my fucking beard. Spray that shit on, man. You know what I'm saying? Spray that shit on. And to be honest, this shit smelled like Cool Breeze or some shit. It was just a random gift she gave me, bro. Smelled like Cool Breeze. Smelled good. I get a lot of compliments on it. One of the ones I had before that was Pure Blanc. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to keep it 100. I get a lot of my workout shit from TJ Maxx, Marshalls, shit like that, right? Bro, when I tell you that I got this little Pure Blanc from TJ Maxx, I ain't ever had so many compliments on a fucking $7 cologne, bro. Like, I've used Tom Ford's, I used Polo's, I've used Gucci, all those. I mean, I get compliments on them, but do not sleep on these $7, $8, $15 colognes from, like, TJ Maxx and Marshalls and shit like that, bro. Grab some of that shit. If it smells good to you, I like that simple shit. I don't like that super strong shit. You know what I'm saying? Just, like, some cool shit. Do not sleep on them stores, bro, because they be having some shit in there that's good. I don't know. I'm just giving y'all some game, man. But do not sleep on them. You feel me? They got some good shit in them stores. But anyways, I'm going to finish up my little routine and shit, and then we're going to hit the street. Boys been in the gym, man. Buzz been hitting them weights. You know what I'm saying? So I want to talk about a comment that I saw in my comment section. And it was on some black pill shit. And one of the dudes was just like, you gotta be 6'3", 6'6", light-skinned Chad with colored eyes or some shit like that to get attention in Brazil. I thought Brazil was for the average dude. Brazil is for everybody. You know what I'm saying? But you gotta have your shit on point. How many times we didn't said that shit for you guys to digest it and understand that you cannot just be no slouch, sloppy-ass dude. That shit ain't gonna get you no play nowhere except for in Asian countries. If we just keep it 100. But even then, like, I feel like a lot of you dudes just don't want to step y'all shit up. I see dudes in the comments all the time talking about if you want better odds with women, just go to Philippines and Thailand. That shit easy, bro. That's easy out there. You can be a regular dusty, you know what I'm saying, don't want to have your shit together, and just be cool with that shit and just settle for the delusion that you could just be with whoever you want and not tighten up and get chicks, bro. Like, so I guess if that's what y'all want to think, that it's better in Asia, then y'all stay there. I'm gonna stay over here. In the second comment I saw, dude was saying it's interesting to see how these dudes show up and Fred and Austin become invisible. As if we don't get chicks all the time. I guess it was because he said, I've never seen five girls in a group giggling and
five guys
wanting to take. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Right here, man. Explain it, bro.
If it's five girls, if there's enough matches for everybody, why the hell would they all not be giggling as a group?
Everybody got their own share that night.
Seven women at the same time. So it ain't about that. Y'all just got to get your shit together. I'm not light skinned.
Y'all got to tighten up, bro.
I'm not light skinned. I don't have colored eyes. And I'm 5'11", so I ain't.
You know what I'm saying? You got to tighten up. Some shit you just can't control, bro. You can't control your color. Can't control your eyes. You can't control your height. You can't control none of that shit, bro. Y'all got this low frequency mindset shit, and y'all all automatically lost before you even get into the goddamn game.
So what y'all need to know too is the group of girls, all five of them, if it wasn't for me, none of them wouldn't have been laughing.
I'm gonna flip this camera around. I'm gonna show you these chicks that just sitting there looking. Good every job. Time I come in here, she be messing with me every time I come in here. We got these two chicks over here choosing heavy than a motherfucker. I'm about to run up on them and ask them why they looking at me like that, because they've been staring at me too long for me to not say nothing. All right, guys, so today's questions is going to be, do you guys like, I'm asking the women, do they prefer a guy who is a nice guy and has money, or a bad boy who only has good sex? So that's the question of the day. And we already know what women in the States think. So let's see how Brazilian women think and see if it's the same or if it's different. I think we've got a chick over here, and we're finna ask her right now, so let's get to it. O que é mais importante? Cara legal, com dinheiro, ou vendido, ou com sexo bom?
Caralho!
Qual?
Eu acho
que
sexo bom.
Sexo bom?
Sexo bom.
Você também?
Aham. Dinheiro a gente já tem.
Você tem dinheiro?
É, eu trabalho com ele, né?
Independente.
So you're independent?
Sou independente.
Let's take a small break real quick. Got the first interview out the question. Got the way. First interview question out the way. I was actually surprised as hell they gave that answer. But anyways, we got the acai on deck. You know what I'm saying? Gotta get the acai, bro. All right, so, o que é mais importante? Cara legal com dinheiro ou vendido com sexo bom? Só o sexo.
Cara legal.
Cara legal?
Cara legal.
Obrigado. O que é mais importante? Cara legal com dinheiro ou vendido aqui? Vendido com só bom sexo? Vendido.
Pode repetir, por favor?
O que é mais importante? Cara legal com dinheiro ou vendido com só sexo bom?
Cara legal.
Cara legal? Você também?
Cara legal.
Você também? Tá. Alright, você primeiro. O que é mais importante? Cara legal com trabalho, ele te respeita, ou vendido, mas ele tem só bom sexo?
Cara legal.
Um cara legal,
com certeza.
E você?
É, um cara... O resto a gente ensina.
Nem tudo, nem completo, né, gente?
É, gente.
Só um cara legal.
Um cara legal.
What up, guys? Back at the crib right now, man. And I'm editing up the video. Today was an interesting video. I came up with that question really, really quick off the top of the dome. And I feel like I might have to run this back on a part two. So if you guys want to see a part two of that, let me know right now in the comments. You know what I'm saying? Drop it right now if you want to see a part two of that. Because today was hella light in the streets and the beach. Wasn't a lot of people out today. So I'm thinking that we should probably do a part two of this video. I really like this question. And just to touch on this question, a lot of women in the US will not fuck with a guy that's a good guy that got his shit together. 9 times out of 10, we know the good guys are not being chosen, right? The guys who are truck drivers or firefighters or police officers or plumbers, people who work with their hands, people who do constructions, people who got good paying jobs that's making 70, 80, 90K, you know what I'm saying? 60, 70K, right? We know those group of guys are getting overlooked, right? So it's either they fucking with the men at the very, very bottom making minimum wage, right? That have this certain thug image, or they skipping over that middle group and going for the 100, 200, 300, 400, 500K earners a year, right? So this was a good example of women that I interviewed today, that a lot of these women here would prefer a guy that is a nice guy and makes good money, right? And we didn't even put a dollar amount on it. We just said a nice guy with money, right? And we know that in Brazil, that ain't a lot. You feel me? On average, that's not a lot. So before anybody tries to say that, oh, these women only fuck with you because you're American, we didn't even put American or Brazilian or anything on the table. We just said a nice guy with money, right? So that could be a Brazilian that has money, or and he's a nice guy, right? Or the thug ass Brazilians, or the thug ass Americans, or the thug ass dude in general, right? We didn't put any category on each guy. We didn't put a nationality on him, right? So if you are a good guy, if you're a nice guy, you have your money, you got your shit together, right? You could have a nice woman here in Brazil, right? Other than the fact that you saw that one first group of women that we approached and said that they want somebody just with good sex. I cannot share the situation that happened with them on camera, but it was some bullshit. So, and now watching this video, it all fucking makes sense. They ain't shit. Anyways, and if they watch this, they know they ain't shit. But anyways, so with that being said, guys, get your shit right, and you can have a nice woman here in Brazil. You don't have to be no high top earner, right? Your money multiplies by 5 when you come to Brazil. So you could be an average earner in the States, right? And women overlooking you anyway. So that's gonna times 5 in Brazil. Now, I know we talked about Floyd, and we gave Floyd many, many, many game on what not to do, right? Floyd makes really good money. Floyd is a cool ass dude. Floyd has charisma. Floyd is our friend, you know what I'm saying? But what you cannot do is show your income within the first couple text messages, right? This is what we told him. Don't do that, bro. You're good. Do everything else you're doing, but don't do that. Now, there's things that you cannot do that's just gonna completely run people off. Don't do that, all right? Everything else, do your shit. Let her like you and love you for you. You feel me? You don't have to overcompensate. You don't have to do any of these things. If she don't want to fuck with you for you, let that bitch go, bro. You feel me? That's anywhere in the States. If she don't want to fuck with you for who you are, let her go, right? I had to throw that in there. You don't have to lead with your money. As long as you make money, as long as you have a nice income, let her choose if she want to deal with you or not. I had to throw that story in there for the simple fact that there is guys who make really good money, right? But they don't truly just care that you're American. You know what I'm saying? They already know you're American because you don't speak the language. 9 times out of 10, they think you're American because you're speaking English. They see the style, blah, blah, blah. So they're just going to assume you're American. You don't have to lead with your money here. That's some shit you do in the United States. You do not have to lead with your money in Brazil, right? So that's why I added that story in there. You don't have to lead. You can be an average earner. You know what I'm saying? You can be an average earner. You don't have to be a six-figure earner to get beautiful, friendly, and nice women, bro. You feel me? So let that be a wake-up call and write that shit down or whatever you want to do to remember that shit. You don't have to be a high earner here. As long as you're a good guy, you know how to treat the women good, and you make a little decent money, it's going to double times five. I mean, it's going to multiply times five when you get here anyway, right? So that with that being said, that brings us back to the other shit that we've been talking about is work on yourself, bro. Fuck the money. You know what I'm saying? We know you got to have money to travel out here. I haven't met any broke-ass dudes that we've met that watch our videos. Every dude that we've met who watched our videos had paper. You feel me? You're not broke traveling here, right? So we know that most of the dudes that travel got bread. That's never not been... No one has ever denied that and doubt that. You feel me? So with that being said, take the time to hit the gym, bro. Even if you're not going to the gym, do some push-ups in the crib. You know what I'm saying? Do some sit-ups at night. Even if you start off doing 30, do something. You feel me? So the physical, bro, I'm telling you. We met some girls, and once we got our answers, we kind of just cut the clip off. But a lot of the chicks that we met today, we asked them side questions. I guess we can do another. If you guys want to see how women, what their response is as far as does a man's physical attributes matter to you, or would you accept him for who he is, right? We asked a couple chicks that, and a lot of the chicks, I think there was like one or two that said, I'll accept them for who they are. But a lot of chicks want to see, they want the guy that they're with to be in fairly decent shape. You ain't got to be like chiseled up and bodybuilder shit, right? Because on average, you don't see those type of guys anyway here. You know what I'm saying? You don't see big, swole-ass bodybuilder type dudes on steroids and shit. You don't see that shit. And if you do see them, they typically by themselves. You don't see them walking with girls, right? The guys you see that's walking with girls a lot of times are the skinny-ass dudes, or the dudes that's kind of built like me. And at times, you'll see bigger guys. But you got to remember, you're already behind the curve because you're not from here. So you got to make sure that you have the ball in your court more times than not, right? Learn the language. Like I said in the beginning of the video, clean shaving. Make sure your shit is on point, right? That shit goes a long way. And I know a lot of people continuously say, oh, if I had to do all this, I would just go, I'll just stay in the States. That's fucking lazy, bro. I don't give a fuck about what nobody say, bro. Yes, the average guy can come to Brazil and have success. I'm a fucking average guy, bro. You know what I'm saying? I didn't struggle with women in the States, but I'm an average guy, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm not no model ass dude that whatever, but I know how to, what I lack in certain things, I make up in other spots. A lot of you guys just choose to not better yourself. You see what I'm saying? Like, you can just show up and wing it. Great. But bro, what is wrong with learning a new language? I met a chick who knew 5 or 6 languages. That is the most attractive and the most beautiful and sexiest thing, that somebody takes the time and the initiative to learn new shit, to better themselves, bro. That's just me. I love when women do that shit. They can speak multiple languages, or they have multiple things that they can do. They're not straight and narrow, right? Women look at men the same way, bro. That shit is intelligent. If you lack one thing, shit, those other things can make up for it. You feel me? So don't sleep on learning a new language, because if you're coming here for a week, I mean, just imagine, bro, your first time coming to Brazil and you can speak very, very basic, elementary, conversational Portuguese. You know what I'm saying? That shit, bro, they be like, damn. When I tell people here, they ask them, you speak really good Portuguese. How long did it take you to learn? I said, I was literally learning for like 2 or 3 months. That shit blows them away, bro. It's like, what the fuck? Like, you're not even from my country, and you're trying to learn. You're putting the foot forward. You're trying to learn my culture. You're trying to do this. You're trying. You're putting in effort, bro. Effort. That's all we're talking about. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a fucking dating coach. I'm not an international or overseas dating coach. I just talk to y'all like I want somebody to talk to me, bro. If I'm slacking, you know what I'm saying? If I'm not moving correctly, shit, tell me. You feel me? You got a lot of people that's selling bullshit online, and saying you could just come here and the grass is gonna be greener and all this shit, bro, you still gotta tighten up. No matter if you go to fucking Russia, no matter if you go to Brazil, a lot of people are talking about go to Thailand and the Philippines and all these Asian countries. But I feel like the people that be commenting, oh, you ain't gotta have all these requirements in the Philippines, that just shows me that you fucking lazy, that you just want the easy way out. You know what I'm saying? I've never been like that, bro. I've always been in sports, athletes. I'm a competitor, bro. So throw me in the fucking fire. I'm gonna come out. You feel me? Like, a lot of people just truly don't want to better themselves. They don't like a challenge. You know what I'm saying? Me personally, Asian women is not my thing, but I go just to experience it. I couldn't live there, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of people go to Philippines and Thailand. Do they have beautiful women there? Yes, but I know my type of woman. You know what I'm saying? I know what I like her to look like physically. All right? Can you find more wives on average in Asia? Absolutely. You know what I'm saying? You're going to find them a lot more there than they are going to be here. Can you find them here? Yes, but 9 times out of 10, you can find them a lot more quicker in Asian countries, bro. We know that. That's not it. But those are just not my type of women. You feel me? It's also a fuck ton cheaper in Asian countries, right? So again, if there's a caveat to it, you know, so it's cheaper, but the women are not my type, right? They're not my style. They're not my preference, right? But they have really great women for long-term relationships and, you know, all the cooperation and things like that. They do what you tell them to do, so on and so forth. So if that's something you're looking for, then that might be the place. But can you find that here in Brazil with all the curves and all that shit? Yes. You know what I'm saying? You can find that here, right? So stop policing where the fuck people go. You know what I'm saying? I know a lot of people sit here and say, you need to go here, you need to go there. Bro, let people go where the fuck they want to go. All right? So stop commenting that shit under my videos, bro. It just shows that you're showing that you don't want to try without physically saying, I don't want to try, right? So don't discourage people and posting this shit under my comments talking about Philippines and Thailand is better because you don't have to, you can just show up as you are. Bro, that shit just screams, I'm an insecure ass dude and I'd just rather be basic. I'd just rather be basic, right? And there's a lot of guys that truly just don't want to be there. You know what I'm saying? They want a challenge. They want, not say, when I say challenge, no. They want to explore the people that they are interested in. You know what I'm saying? Brazil has every color, every, you know what I'm saying? You want white or all the way to the dark. They have it, all right? If you want Brazilian mixed with Asian, they got it here. You want Brazilian, the indigenous Indian look, they have all of that shit here, bro. You know, and there's more, and as black men, I would say there's white men who prefer Asians more than black men. There is black men that prefer it. But at the same time, there is black men love curves. You know what I'm saying? And just based off of the many, 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 many people I've talked to, a lot of the chicks that's in those areas like the Philippines or Thailand that's thick and got all the curves, shit, all the niggas didn't have them. You know what I'm saying? Because dudes like curves. Dudes like a big ass. Dudes like titties. Dudes like all these curvy and juicy, all that. You know what I'm saying? So 9 times out of 10, she already then been ran through by all the other dudes. You know what I'm saying? And don't let her be fine as hell and got that. And she Asian? Duh. I'm on that. Duh. So you're going to have a better chance of finding it here, right? It's just, I don't know, bro. Anyways, man, long story short, work on yourself. As you've seen in this video, be a nice guy, be a good guy, be yourself, right? Be yourself, have your money, and you can get a good chick in Brazil. You know what I'm saying? A lot of these chicks are not looking for no thug ass dude here. A lot of these chicks are not looking for nobody that ain't got shit going just because you got good dick. They don't care about that shit. You know what I'm saying? They don't care about that. Will you have women here who care about that and that's all they want? Yes. But just look at the video, bro. How many girls, even in the group of girls, I think I did a group of three and some other ones, right? So I interviewed like a couple. You've seen the damn video, shit. So I'm recording this after I did all this. I'm in the crib right now. So out of all those girls I interviewed today, only that one, that first clip of those two said that, right? All the rest of them was, they want a guy that's gonna treat them good. They want a nice guy. They got some money, you know what I'm saying? But we know their money is different from ours. So our very minimum money is 5 times more here, right? They don't care that you're American, right? So like I told you guys the story, they don't care that you're American. They don't care that you have money. You can make $10,000 a month in the US. That's 50K here, bro. That's like 53, 54K here in their money. That's a lot of fucking money a month, right? If they don't want to fuck with you, they don't want to fuck with you. You can be an asshole with that money, but they don't care. You know what I'm saying? You can be doing the wrong shit with that same amount of money. On average, they don't care, bro. They want a nice guy, right? They want a guy that's going to be able to treat them good. They want a guy that's going to be able to make them feel not awkward. Shit like that. You know, they want a guy that's going to be a nice, cool guy, right? That they also are attracted to. So, guys, that's it for this video. Make sure you guys hit the like button, comment, share the video, subscribe if you are new to the channel, man. We're gonna keep pumping these videos out. We're actually about to go out to the Philippines in a few weeks. You know what I'm saying? We're about to go out there. We're gonna see. We're gonna see what's up. They speak English out there, so it should be a lot more easier to navigate and talk with people. But again, I'm willing to learn new languages, bro. I think that shit is dope. You feel me? Anyways, guys, we got this video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys want to see you guys are loving the interaction, the boots on the ground, the interviews with the chicks. If you guys want to see this more often, let me know in the comments what questions that you want me to ask them. You know what I'm saying? I haven't been in the States for a while, so I don't know the drama and shit that's going on. I try to stay clear of all the bullshit there because it doesn't matter. I don't live there no more. So drop some topics that's going around right now, right? So I'll translate into Portuguese and ask them, okay, what do you think about this or what do you think about that? If you guys know some questions that you want me to ask them, let me know. If you guys want to see a part two to this same question, let me know, right? And we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.